I'm going to be doing a review on this little baby right here by a very innovative company called The Ordinary, and this is the Vitamin C Suspension 23% plus hyaluronic acid of 2%. Now, The Ordinary is all the rage right now. It is breaking open everything, and it's probably giving a lot of other companies that's been around for a long time a run for their money. And if you haven't heard of the brand The Ordinary by Deciem, you will after this. This baby packs a big punch. And for only $5.80, wait, Canadian, not even US prices. Canadian, and it's made by it has L-Ascorbic acid in it, which packs an amazing punch. But before we get into all the goodies of this little baby right here, because we're going to be talking about the company, we're going to be talking about the vitamin C, we're going to be talking about, what are we going to be talking about? The line itself, and of course, my experience with it, because it's very experiential. And if that's even a word. But before we get into all that, this is gonna be a really fun video because it is my first ever collab, and what better way to collab but with my friends, the HauteMamasLive. And they are two dynamic duos. They're so amazing, and they do, they're hot mamas, they do beauty reviews, they do makeup demos on for like more geared to like the more mature, experienced skin. Hooded eyes, like I got some major hooded eyes here. And as you get older, you kind of get a little bit more hooded. They do unboxings, they do hauls, they do subscription boxes, and they are so much fun. Their names are Lisa and Jacqueline, and I want you after this to head over to their channel and watch their amazing video, because they're also going to be doing a review on this. Also, they have a whole bunch of other goodies by The Ordinary, so you're going to be able to get a well-rounded review on The Ordinary. Now, what you do is I'm going to put a little link up here, the eye up here, to head on over to their channel when you're finished with mine. And then you're going to, I'm going to put a link, of course, in my description box, and then I am going to put on the end screen a link to them, so you can't miss it. They are so hot, so it's gonna be so much fun. Oh, and I just wanted to say how we ended up collabing too was because, funny enough, we both bought The Ordinary products at the same time. So when we found out about it, we decided, why not collab? So that's what we are doing. I want to give you a little background on The Ordinary, because they're a really amazing and innovative brand. And this is the bag that I got when I went to the store, because I actually went to the store, and it was a really kind of funny store because it's in Yorkville. And so they just opened up just recently a number of stores in Toronto. And of course, it's homegrown. This company, people don't speak about it a lot, but it's actually, the company started out in Toronto, my hometown of Toronto. So I'm very proud. So anyway, yeah. So anyway, when I went to the store, it's so cool. It's in this hip happening place called Yorkville, and the front of the store is full of glass. But I thought, I didn't know that it was where you, you see, if you watch my hot yoga meltdown, So if you watched my hot yoga emergency meltdown, you'll know that I have major problems with glass, and their whole frontage on Yorkville is full, sorry, I had to change the lighting, is full of glass. And they had this odd step in front of it, cement step with a grass on the tops of the steps. So it kind of looks like a window box. So I'm going to the front thinking, well, no, that is a window box. So there isn't any door there. And I'm like, haha. And so I'm walking around this place trying to find the door. And the wonderful salesperson realized that I was totally clued out and went to the front of the window and opened it. And I realized it was actually steps up on that grassy knoll into the store. So that was my flub in trying to get into this store. So I wanted to tell you a little bit about the brand The Ordinary and the company, because it is this like really innovative company. They do a lot of, their main thrust is for anti-aging skincare and very active anti-aging ingredients. And The Ordinary is their one of their lines. And it's under the brand, the name Deciem, the abnormal beauty company. And Deciem means, they took it from the word decima, which means 10 in a sequence. And the very, very interesting thing about this is that the owner is Brandon, what's his name again? Brandon Truax. And he, they have, what is it? Well, the brand is Deciem, 10 in a sequence, and he created actually not one, not two, but 10 beauty lines. Some of them skincare, some of them hand and body care, hair care, and which is incredibly innovative of him, because most companies stick with one line of beauty products, and then maybe if they get really big, they'll buy out and stuff like that. But he said, no, 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 I'm not gonna do it that way. I'm gonna be my own conglomerate and created 10 beauty lines. So that's why his company is called Deciem. Yeah. And his quote is, he looks so cute. He's like a GQ guy. He's absolutely brilliant. And his quote is, he likes to say, because he likes to be a little bit off the wall. He says, smiling is dangerous because it gives you wrinkles. However, if you see his YouTube video promoting his line with his partner, he smiles all the way through it. He's just so friendly, fun-loving, approachable guy, and he has this, like, he's full of energy. You can see the guy is brilliant, and he's like almost like a panther ready to pounce. He's got so much energy, and it's almost childlike about him. So he's completely the opposite of that quote. He smiles all the time. He's almost giggly. So he's really, really sweet, and you can tell the man is brilliant. His approach is anti-aging ingredients and making them simple enough so that they're very, very affordable. And he's just, again, I told you, he's just opened up like 4 stores in Toronto. And I believe there's 1 or 2 stores in Vancouver. These are the storefronts. It's now in Sephora, but not The Ordinary line. His other lines, Hyalamide is there, I believe. And I think Neod is also there at Sephora. So that's pretty impressive. He's also sells through the UK through victoriahealth.com. I will list them in the description box. So, and it's a cruelty-free, paraben-free, what else free? I'm listing all that. Paraben-free, sulfate-free, silicone-free, but we're gonna get into the silicone because it's kind of interesting. They don't believe in putting animal oils in it either, no mineral oils, so it's pretty amazing. We're gonna get to the importance of vitamin C first, because there are 4 anti-aging ingredients that you absolutely need to have in your skincare arsenal. Once you have these 4, everything is all fluff and extras around it. The other things are important, but these 4 things are really important to have in your anti-aging. Sunscreen, number 1. We all talk about sunscreen. Exfoliants, and I believe in having not only a chemical exfoliant, but a physical exfoliant. Then you have vitamin A, very important. That is retin A, retinol, retinoic acid, retinol palmitate. The last ones are more milder forms. Retin A is the strongest. And then you have vitamin C. And with this particular one, now The Ordinary sells a number of other under their line. They sell three other vitamin C's, but this one is L-ascorbic acid. And L-ascorbic acid, first of all, let me read you the quote that they have online about L-ascorbic acid. The Ordinary site says, L-ascorbic acid has been shown, it's the most studied vitamin C, shown to reverse multiple signs of skin aging while brightening the skin when applied topically. So this L-ascorbic acid is 23%, which is the highest amount of L-ascorbic acid you can put in a skincare product. You cannot go any higher unless you're doing it in an ester form. The ester form is 25%. And they do sell the ester form of L-ascorbic acid in their hyalamide version. And that's about $38, whereas this, again, is $5.80. Now, the brightening aspects of L-ascorbic acid is that it will brighten your skin. It will even out your skin tone, get rid of discolorations, uneven skin tone, acne scars, sunspots, and age spots. I have a big whammy right here of an age spot. It hasn't gotten rid of it yet. I'm still hoping, but I will tell you my experience on it and the reason why I haven't seen those results as yet. But who knows? You never know. The other thing that it does is because vitamin C is an antioxidant, so it's a free radical scavenger. And what it does is it, how does it do it? It stops free radicals from attacking your skin collagen. So, and it keeps it from breaking down your skin collagen. So it's a collagen builder of your skin. It repairs the damage of your skin, evens out your skin tone, firms your skin, helps get rid of wrinkles. The results will start between 6 to 12 weeks, so that 12 weeks is about 3 months. And vitamin C is for the long haul. You may see initial brightening at the beginning. Especially if you've never used vitamin C before, you may see initial brightening at the beginning within the 6 to 12 week mark. But vitamin C is meant to be used for the long haul. It's gonna keep those wrinkles from coming. It's gonna keep your skin plump. It's gonna keep the collagen there so you're not losing it. It's gonna even out your skin tone. The only side effect that you, one of the side effects that you can have, there is a possibility that you may get pimples from it. It depends on whether you're sensitive to it for that. And this is a high dose. This is the highest dose that they can have. So there is a possibility for that. And of course, stinging. And we'll get into that later. The Ordinary line is so amazing because their whole approach is to make these anti-aging ingredients affordable and accessible to everybody. Brandon doesn't believe that we need to have these super expensive products on the market. You can simplify it down so that it becomes accessible for everybody. And this is what he did with this. So all of their line, except for Buffet, has a lot, has about 2 to 3 active ingredients in each of their Ordinary products. And with that, they don't add any extra fillers like fermented enzymes, fermented ingredients, essential oils, extracts. Those ingredients take longer to produce, so they're gonna cost more. So he doesn't have that. Includes the baseline of the active ingredients that are gonna really impact your skin in a nice, simple base, so that it's not going to cost prohibitive. The packaging is very simple. It's just in a tube bottle, or they'll have it in the little tincture bottles like that. So it's very simple, easy packaging. Doesn't cost a lot of money. So you're just going to get your active products in here. They have the other, of course, I mentioned that they have other lines that slightly go up in price, but not to the point where they're costing like phenomenal amounts. Like this vitamin C, $5.80 Canadian. Drunk Elephant, which is a more elegant product that's going to have all the extracts and essential oils and fermented products, is costing you $100, and then it comes in an airless pump bottle so you can control the amount that you get out. But The Ordinaire keeps it simple, so it's we can afford to get this and it still works. About this one, this is again 23% vitamin C ascorbic acid. Now, problem with ascorbic acid is that this is the stable form, and you can keep it stable when you don't dissolve it in water. So this is not dissolved in water, so it's very stable. It will last a long time. It's not one of these things that degrades within 3 months, so you're not going to have to rush to use it up and then it turns orange and then it's old. So it's very stable. The other side to that is not an elegant product. Of course, the packaging isn't elegant. The reason why is that you feel the vitamin C crystals. It's not dissolved. So that's why they call it a suspension, because it's suspended in, this is like chemistry, it's suspended in a base. The base that it's suspended in, of course, is the hyaluronic acid 2% spheres. And that hyaluronic acid really is a humectant. It draws in the water and the moisture into your skin and holds it in there. And it helps to buffer the vitamin C, because this is a very potent form of vitamin C. It's the highest. I keep on repeating myself on that, but it is. It's very high. And so it helps to, it not only nourishes your skin and gives you the humectants, it also helps to buffer your skin. And it also includes squalene in here as a base and coconut alkanes. I'm going to get back to coconut alkanes, because the coconut alkanes, I have a feeling, is what is making it feel oily. If you do it the normal, if you approach this by using it the normal way as a serum, you're going to feel the oiliness in it. I do, anyway. If you don't do it that way, you mix it in with your moisturizer, make sure that you're not mixing in with anything with niacinamide, because it will cancel out the effects of ascorbic acid. You won't feel the oil. Yes. It's kind of like the crystals are finer than, I would say, much finer than the microcrystals in Visanti. These are dermabrasial crystals. It feels like that on your skin, except tinier and less of them. And then they suggest that because it's such a high amount, and I think it's because it's a little oily too, best to use in the evening. Mainly, generally, you use ascorbic acid, vitamin C in the morning serum, and I don't care. I use it in the morning. Now, I have super, super sensitive skin. Not only that, I have sensitive eyes. I nearly took out my eyes with Retin-A Micro one time, and I didn't even put it anywhere near my eyes, and I didn't even use it every day. So that's telling you, within a month and a half, my eyes were taken out. I was on steroid drops off and on. Don't tell my doctor this, but I was on steroid drops off and on for a freaking year to heal my eyes. So I have to be super careful with my skin and with my eyes. And because this is 23%, and I've never used a 23% before, I used to use Celexi in the past, and it was about 10% and 15%. I don't think I ever got higher than 15%. So with this, when I asked the store, the salesperson, he was really so kind, and he said, mix it in with your moisturizer, maybe use it every other day. So that's how I started to use it. So I've been using it for about a month and a half now, and I mix it with my CeraVe. CeraVe, it's a very basic moisturizer, because it's I don't normally use CeraVe, but my mom left it behind when she was visiting, and it's a very lovely, simple moisturizer with glycerin and ceramides and hyaluronic acid. There isn't a lot of other active ingredients in it, because which is fine by me, because I like my active ingredients in my serums. So I like to keep them in my serums and stuff like that. So in my toners and stuff. So what I did is, to start, was I mixed this in with the CeraVe. When I did that, and I did it for like every other day or every third day, and when I did it like that, I never even notice the crystals of the vitamin C. So I'm wondering, what are they talking about? And I didn't notice the oiliness. So I'm going, what are they talking about, oiliness? I remember one person mentioned it. Not many people have mentioned this. And the crystals, so I'm going, what are they talking about? Because it melted, it basically dissolved right in before I even put it on my face. So I didn't notice that. And I, thank goodness, I didn't know any tingling. I didn't get any tingling from it, which is a possibility because it's so potent. So I did not have any problems. So far, so good. So I decided, okay, after about 2 weeks, I thought, okay, now I can go for broke and try it on my skin directly because I did want to see what they were talking about, the vitamin C crystals, that experience, and possibly the oiliness. So what I do is I always wash my face. I always put my toner on. Then I always put HauteMamasLive, this is a hyaluronic acid essence with about 3 versions of hyaluronic acid. So I put this on first. I do like to put this on first before I put my vitamin C to give that extra buffer to my skin. You don't have to do that. You can go on right away after your toner with the vitamin C, but I like to buffer my skin because again, my skin is so sensitive. So I always put this on in my routine. So I put this on before I put the vitamin C. Then I put this on, and let me tell you, I felt those crystals on my skin, just as everybody was saying, and dang thing would not melt. And in fact, I'm showing you a cut in of how I, you know, rub it in. The other thing about it is because it's not a pump, it's hard to get the right amount on your face, right? Because it, and so I like to store my bottle this way in the box. I keep it in the box and I store it this way, not this way, the normal way, because I don't want to then open it up and it, the cream, the serum pops out too much. So it was hard to kind of get the right amount. At first you're trying to get it out and it hardly comes out, and then it comes out too much. So that's the other thing about these bottles that I find a little bit difficult is because of that. So in my demo, a lot came out. So you will see how oily it gets. Here, that my skin is still a bit shiny. See? Still shiny. Makes. So basically, it acts like microcrystal exfoliating your skin. So don't try to rub it in and keep on rubbing because you will exfoliate your skin. If you want a little bit of exfoliation that way, go for it. If your skin is tough enough to do it, go for it. I don't get that much tingling. Once or twice I felt a little tingle from the actual crystals on my face, but I'd rub it in a little bit. And yes, you are exfoliating a little bit with those crystals, but I'm telling you, they will not melt into your skin. Maybe if you've got very hot skin, they might, but they don't melt into my skin. So what I do is I rub it in, let it almost exfoliate a little bit, and then I wait a couple of minutes to 15 minutes, and then I add my serum. And it's just any old serum. Make sure it doesn't have, again, niacinamide. Rub that in. You may still feel a little bit of those crystals. I then, what do I do? Then I wait a couple of minutes and then I add my cream. Or what I will do is I'll go wash my hands after my serum, go wash my hands, take care of my kitties, give them their morning treats, my breakfast, go back and then put my moisturizer on. By then, everything is kind of soaked in, and once I put my moisturizer on, rub that in, everything will go. But I forgot to mention, when you put this on, not only are you going to feel the crystals, you're going to feel the oil. It feels oily. I didn't notice it at all when I mix it into my moisturizer, but you definitely notice it. Well, anyway, I do when I do it on its own the way you're normally supposed to do. After my HauteMamasLive, I put this on, I feel the oiliness. You're rubbing and rubbing and rubbing. you don't get the crystals coming absorbing in, they don't dissolve, and you feel the oiliness. Then I wait to help the oiliness soak in, add my moisturizer, or go feed the kitties and do my moisturizer. But I always wash my hands because this stuff is strong before I feed my kitties. Then I add the moisturizer. By that time, it will still be a bit oily when I add my moisturizer in, but then I'll wait about 10-15 minutes and then it soaks in and I'm fine. I know it sounds like a process, but believe me, if you're not in a rush, there is a learning curve to this, but you can get it to absorb and then you can put on your full face. I don't have any problems, but if I'm in a rush and I gotta get to work quickly, I'm just gonna mix it into my moisturizer. If I'm not so much in a rush and I can handle kind of waiting it out in between layers to get the oil to absorb, I will do that. If that bothers you, you may not like this type of vitamin C, or if you have no problems with mixing it into your moisturizer, you'll be fine. You will not feel the oiliness that way, and you definitely won't feel the crystals either. But if you don't like the crystals or you don't like that oily sensation, try and do it by waiting the layers out a little bit, and especially after you've then rubbed in your moisturizer, wait maybe 15 minutes. It will absorb and then you can go on. And if you don't like that oil, then maybe try the other vitamin C's. They have other vitamin C products in the ordinary line that may not be so oily. I wanted to know why this vitamin C had that oiliness. What is in, there's gotta be something in this ingredient line, in this ingredient deck. So I'm suspecting it might be the coconut alkanes. Coconut alkanes in this. So I looked at what coconut alkanes is, and it turns out coconut alkanes is a reduction. I was gonna say distill, but the correct word is the reduction and hydrogenation of fatty acids from coconut oil. And it's a plant-derived silicone. So even though they don't believe in putting silicone in their products, they are technically putting in a silicone, but it is a plant-derived silicone. So that might be the reason why it feels oily, is from the coconut alkanes. And the reason why they don't agree with putting silicones in their products, and I've always suspected it, Paula's Choice likes to do that a lot, especially in their serums. There's a lot of choice. She does like to use a lot of silicones in her products, like dimethicone, cyclomethicone, or whatever. Whatever cones. X-Anes? Anyway, she likes to put a lot of cones in her products, and especially in their serums. And I've always suspected that. I was wondering whether it might be like suffocating the anti-aging ingredients in there, all the good stuff, and so that your skin is not really absorbing it all. And that is exactly the reason why they don't, The Ordinary and Brandon not believe in putting silicones in their products, for that exact reason, is that they feel that it is encasing the active ingredients and keeping your skin from being able to absorb it. So they do not like putting silicones in their products, and I agree with that. However, with this one, they are putting a plant-derived silicone, coconut alkanes, and that could be the possibility as to why possibly you're getting that oily feel. I wanted to tell you I didn't get that much tingling from it at all, except once or twice when I was rubbing it in a little bit, and the little microcrystals of the vitamin C stung a touch. The other thing is, what I noticed is when I did it straight up the normal way as a serum, I noticed by the evening when I washed my face, I noticed a bit of roughness to my skin, like it felt congested. But in the morning, by morning time, it had disappeared. Now, I had an extreme version of this twice happen to me, where it was actually an allergic reaction, and it started off with my skin becoming very, very rough to the touch, and then it just started to get drier and drier and rougher, and you could almost see it, and then it started to peel, like it was peeling everywhere. It was like a salamander. It was very embarrassing. I went on a I went on a date like that, which was ridiculous. But anyway, you got to do what you got to do. So, and it kind of felt like the beginnings of that. So I almost kind of panicked, you know, inside wondering, oh my God, am I going to have another reaction to that? So, so far, no. But I do notice that I get a little bit of that weird sensation of a congested rough skin, and then in the morning it's gone. So I have a feeling I am slightly sensitive to this strength of vitamin C, because when I used to use Celex C at 10% or 15%, I never had that issue. So it just could be because my skin's getting used to it, and it is strong and potent. But so, I haven't noticed this my sunspot, age spot going away. I've had this ever since I was like late 20s, early 30s. It just popped up on my skin and it's never left me. So who knows? It will be interesting if I do it every day and I can do it the serum way, whether it will go. I think that The Ordinary by Deciem is a pretty amazing line, and I'm so glad I found out about this. I am so happy that they are in my area and I can just go to the storefront and peruse all their stuff and buy it outright and not even have to think about shipping or anything like that. I think it's a fabulous line. I love their whole take on wanting to make this affordable, and that they don't feel that it's necessary to make this expensive and put all these expensive extras. And thank goodness you have the option of going up in their other beauty lines to check out their more formulated products. But this is a great way to start. What I would love to see with them though is that if they would do an L-ascorbic acid where they provide it in a lower strength, so that people starting off don't have to deal with such a strong, you know, not everybody can handle it. It's, you have to be careful with this, and this is one of the things I forgot to mention is care instructions. If you're just starting out on vitamin C, I actually wouldn't recommend starting it out with 23%. Might be a good idea to check their other vitamin C's and start with the lowest strength possible before you head on up to this one. And if you are doing this one, you want to start with this one, maybe use it every other day, or start with mixing it into your moisturizer. It does have a learning curve. You do have to put up with the micro crystals of the vitamin C. If you don't like that, mix it into your moisturizer. You're still going to get the good effects of it that way. And watch out, you may want to do a patch test first to make sure that you're not going to have a reaction to this, because again, it is the strongest form. But all in all, I think this is a fantastic product, and it's great if you're balling on a budget or you don't want to spend like $100 on the Drunk Elephant or any of the other vitamin C's, because most of them are like $100 or over right now. $5.80 is like, listen, who can argue with that, right? So, amazing product. If you would like to have an update for me, because I've only used it for about a month and a half and I haven't been able to use it every day yet because I have to take care of my eyes. So if you would like an update from me in about 6 months, and if you would like me to test out any of the other products in their line, let me know. I'd be willing to do that, except for the buffet. I can't do the buffet. I can't do any peptides or Matrixyl or anything like that. But I will leave it up to the Haute Mama's Lab, because they are going to be testing out the buffet. Definitely head on over to them after this to test out, to get their take on the vitamin C and their experience with it. And I believe they're going to be reviewing the buffet and a whole bunch of others. So check them out, the dynamic duo of Haute Mamas Live. And if you like tried any of these amazing products and you want to let me know about them, any more information, or if you have any questions, please leave it in the description box below. And remember, Haute Mamas Live is up on the eye there, is in my description box, will be on my end plate. And so if you you enjoyed this video and you got a lot of great information out of that. I hope I was able to give you some good information and it made some sense. So if you did enjoy it, please give it a thumbs up, a like, and do remember to subscribe to keep up with all my videos. And what else? And remember, rock your own kind of beauty and keep on going and keep on glowing. I will. Oh my God. And remember, head on over to the dynamic sister duo, Hot Mamas Live, for their take on the super affordable, the ordinary, the not so ordinary skincare line. And you see my mugshot over there? Just click on that to subscribe, and Pixie Sparkles.